Trust it.
Hey everybody, Dr. O here. In this video, we're going to talk about the halogens that can be used to as antimicrobials that can chemically control microbial growth. So you see here, iodine, chlorine, and fluorine. We're just going to talk about iodine and chlorine. First of all, let's talk about what halogens are. Let's go to the periodic table for just a moment. So here we have the periodic table. So the halogens, there you see the iodine, chlorine, and fluorine. So halogens are in group 7A on the periodic table, which means they really, really want an electron because they want to behave like the noble gases they're sitting next to. So they're going to be scavenging and pulling electrons from anywhere that they can. That's important because that's how they work. So I'm going to go back to the first page here. So they work by oxidation. So remember, oxidation is removing electrons from something. So halogens are going to bump into things. And what really matters here is, like it says there, the destabilization of cellular macromolecules. So halogens are going to bump into things like sulfur-containing amino acids, your nucleotides that make up your DNA and RNA, etc., fatty acids like in your phospholipid bilayer of your cell membranes, and it's going to oxidize them. It's going to pull electrons away from them, which is going to destabilize them. So it's basically this oxidation effect that comes from where they're sitting at the periodic table is what makes them work. All right, so you see lots of different examples here. So let me go ahead and give you a couple of them. Let me jump back into. So here we see betadine being used. So betadine is actually an iodophore, and that's going to be when you take iodine and mix it with organic molecules, and that's going to make it more stable, and it's going to be able to persist longer. So that's why it makes it more effective. You can also find halogens mixed in tinctures with alcohol, but the iodophores are the most important one. So here we see betadine. It's an iodophore. It's called provodone iodine, and it's very effective on skin. So there's an example of using iodine on skin. All right, and then we see chlorine. Obviously, when you think of chlorine, especially in a microbiology class, we should think of water treatment. So it's kind of neat how chlorine works. So when you take gaseous chlorine and mix it with water, it forms a powerful oxidant called hypochlorous acid. And that's the key, right? The chlorine gas isn't antimicrobial in that form. When it becomes hypochlorous acid, that's when it becomes very antimicrobial. So that's why we add chlorine to our water to chemically treat it. One last thing to note here about hypochlorous acid is it is uncharged, which basically means that it can move in and out of cells just like water does, and that's what allows it to get inside of cells. So that would be the chlorine used for water treatment becomes this hypochlorous acid that is antimicrobial. So you did like sodium hypochlorite would be one of the key examples there. Sodium hypochlorite is actually what's in bleach. So the same thing. So treating your water using bleach, it forms this hypochlorous acid. Then you have this strong oxidation reaction that kills the microbes. If you've ever lived somewhere where they've put as much chlorine in your drinking water as they can, and there are other ways to treat water. We'll cover that in separate videos, like using ozone and stuff. But if they've added all the chlorine they can to your water, what they will then add is chloramines. So chloramines are actually going to be more stable, so they're going to release chlorine over longer periods of time. So what you see here is a chloramine is ammonia, where these hydrogens are going to be replaced with chlorines. That's what a chloramine is. So the reason that you would use them in water if you needed to is because they do persist longer. So if you can't kill all the contamination in drinking water with chlorine, you would add the chloramine. So one just kind of little neater added bonus here. But if they do have to put chloramines in your drinking water, they usually send out strong warnings not to use this kind of water in your fish tanks. Now, chlorine can hurt fish too, so obviously you can remove that. But since chloramines persist longer, way more likely to kill your fish. And that's why if you have fish tanks, you buy those chemical treatments that remove the chloramine and the chlorine from the water. Okay? All right, so those are your two clinically significant halogens, iodine and chlorine, and I hope this helps. Have a wonderful day. Be blessed.